Hi, this is John Cole with GrowingYourGreens.com. Today we're at the Exotica Rare Fruit Tree Nursery, 2508B East Vista Way here in beautiful Vista, California. So we're outside basically in the San Diego area, and this is an amazing place. I've heard about it so much and I'm glad to finally be here again. I was here once before. Glad to be making a video to share it with you. I, you know, literally travel the world and all around to find new seeds, plants, and trees I could grow at my property, like you've seen, and I'm wanting to get some exotic trees today. So let's go inside and check it out. All right, so we're at the entrance here, the Exotica Fruit Nursery, and let's come inside and check it out. Oh, and their hours are, they're usually open until about 5 or 6 p.m., so definitely give them a call first to find out their exact hours. Oh, their phone number is 760-724-9093. All right, so we're here at Exotica Fruit Nursery, and this is an example of air layering. So this is how they propagate a tree, basically. What they do, and you can see all these silver balls on the tree, and it looks kind of crazy, and you might think, oh, what are they covering fruit? Well, no, what they're doing is they literally take the branch and they scar it, so they put some, like, take a razor and just slice off some of the bark, then they'll basically damage it, and then they're gonna wrap it up with some soil in a plastic bag, and then they put the aluminum foil over it and seal it down there, and then over time what'll happen is where the tree was scarred and it comes to contact with the soil, then the tree will grow brand new roots. And the tree will grow brand new roots, and then once they do this for a while, that it'll be basically roots will be in this ball. They'll cut off the tree, so like right here, they maybe air layered above this, they'll cut it off. Then they'll plant that in a pot, and presto, they have a new tree they could basically sell to you. Some people say that air layered trees maybe aren't as strong because the roots aren't grown from naturally, they just kind of grow out, but you know, it seems good enough for most people. All right, so it's March, not the best time to visit Exotica here, but you know, there are still things growing and almost ripe. So here's one of my favorite trees. This is an evergreen. I planted one from seed actually, so I have an unnamed variety and I'm crossing my fingers that it's gonna be really sweet. But here at Exotica, they have different varieties of loquats. Actually, one of them was called golden apricot. So you could only imagine, you know, a loquat in the wild could just be really small and the seeds are really big and there's usually not a lot of flesh. But here at Exotica, you know, here's an example. This one's almost ripe, and this is a pretty darn big loquat. So we're gonna pick it off, and on the loquats, you know, you don't want to eat the skin, so usually I'll peel the skin off. In this case, we'll use my thumbnail to try to break it up a little bit. And what you're gonna do is we're gonna cut it open. Try to cut it open without losing too much juice here. And as you can see, they have these nice big pits in the middle, and you don't eat the pits, but what you're gonna do is you're gonna eat the flesh. So as you can see, there's this basically seed coating you don't eat either. You can eat it, but it doesn't really taste too good. And then you're just gonna eat the flesh. This one could be a little bit riper. I could taste that it will be really good here. But yeah, so there's just a little bit of flesh on every loquat fruit, but they're excellent, I love them. All right, so this is where they propagate probably lots of plants here, and you can see they just did cuttings of something, and I'm not exactly sure what it is. I think they're labeled. But yeah, they start all the plants and the trees just like this. They'll take cuttings and maybe some rooting hormone and the trees will grow, and you can see the different stages. So this is, you know, the fresh cuttings, and now these are growing more, and then they transplant them up to little pots like this. And they have literally hundreds of plants here, and this is just one area. They have greenhouses there and just plants everywhere. This is an amazing place to visit if you're into trees, into fruit trees. You could just, you know, walk around and just be in amazement and awe on all the different varieties they have here at Exotica Fruit Nursery here in Vista, California. So have you ever had a dragon fruit before? I have, and I know I love them. They're kind of similar to the inside of a kiwi, but they're not acidic at all, and depending on the variety and if they're ripe or not, they can be very, very sweet, and they're delicious. I love dragon fruits, and here at Exotica Fruit Nursery, ow, they got thorns. But this is a dragon fruit vine here. It's a cactus family, and they have little thorns on them, and you know, they'll get you like it just got me. And this variety is actually, let's see, there's a picture of it, and I was reading it. Oh, this is a Vietnamese Jaina, giant white flesh. And so this is a white variety of, oh man, it's getting me, of the dragon fruit, and that's how they grow. I don't see any flowers or any fruit on here at this time of year, and I have heard they can be harder or hard to pollinate. If you do get dragon fruit, you want to get at least a couple different varieties so they could cross-pollinate, and you'll have the best success of getting some fruits. All right, so besides selling a lot of different plants already in pots, you know, they have a lot of tropical and exotic fruits just planted in the ground. So as you're wandering around, checking out everything in the pots that you could buy and bring home, they also have plants and fruits growing in the ground. So we did, there's citrus behind us, and we saw some grapefruit, and you know, here's some avocados, and here's an avocado tree right here. This is how avocados grow on the vine. They just kind of hang down, and normally they snip them off and then you'll buy them. And I haven't known them to ripen on the tree. Usually they ripen off the tree. And even here in San Diego here, this tree is getting some damage. Certain varieties of avocados are more frost tolerant, or could handle the colder temperatures. And where I live, it's, let's see, I'm growing the Mexicali variety. So that's more frost tolerant, but still I covered it. So they can be challenging to grow. And you know, a lot of people may start the avocados from seed, but avocados, if you start from seed, you know, you pretty much don't know what you're gonna get. And that's how that goes. So this is an example of grafting, actually. So this was a seedling fig tree that basically grew from seed, an unnamed variety. They basically cut it off and now they graft it on. I think it's called white kink. So these are cuttings off a new fig tree or a different fig tree. They basically grafted it on to where this old fig tree was, and then these are gonna bud out and grow into basically the new fig tree. So up to this point is an unnamed variety. Then from here on, the old fig tree is actually, you know, still alive, and it's gonna keep these things growing and growing into the new tree. And that's how they propagate many trees, is by cuttings. And you can see a lot of the cut marks on a lot of trees, and then you could see where they basically grafted on or spliced on a new variety. So many rootstocks in your local nursery will be basically grafted. It gets interesting when underneath the graft, then roots and branches start to grow out, and then you have two varieties of figs, and maybe this variety is not as tasty. I think my apricot tree might be doing that. So this is a curiosity here. This is called the ice cream bean tree, and they're really quite unique. Some people like them, some people don't. It's basically a bean. You open up the bean, and inside the bean around the seed is actually this white fluffy stuff, and they say it tastes like ice cream. It's nice and fluffy and has a definitely unique flavor. I had some when I was in Peru. But this tree's grown up literally through the greenhouse, and you could see at one time it was in the pot over there, and it literally busted out of the pot, grew through into the ground, and shot up this big giant trunk up through the top of the greenhouse here. And now, you know, that's just how it's living. And I think it's really cool. And if you could grow an ice cream bean tree, they actually, from seed, they grow really quickly and will fruit fairly quickly, so they're pretty quick to grow if you're in Hawaii or someplace like Florida, or maybe here even in the San Diego area. Definitely, I probably can't grow it where I'm at. It gets too cold. So this is a curry tree. This is the real curry spice flavoring. Not the curry you buy in the store that's, you know, a mixture of different spices. This is the real curry. And what you do is you literally just take a leaf off this curry tree. And, you know, in India, where this is from, this is curry. They take this leaf, they literally dry it and powder it, and that is the curry seasoning. Of course, you can eat the fresh leaf, and wow, this has an amazing flavor. I don't know that it tastes like the curry that I know, but it has an amazing, interesting flavor. It's good. I did try to grow it once, not frost tolerant. So there's many trees planted in the ground here at Exotica Fruit Nursery, and this is just one of them. A massive chirimoya tree that's planted right there, and it's a nice big cover up top, and you know, here's the chirimoyas that are definitely hard, not yet ripe. But chirimoya is on the tree here at Exotic Fruit Nursery. They have so many other different trees, you know, that are in the ground. And 20 years of work is here, you know, on the grounds, put into this great place that you should visit and support. All right, so I've decided today that I'm going to pick up a couple jelly palm plants. So this will grow where I live, and it's going to keep its foliage all year long, keep the green foliage and not drop its leaf like other plants. I love the evergreens. So these are jelly palms. They have a small fruit, tastes like between a pineapple-ish style fruit. So when you're picking out your plants, you know, we have all these different plants here. You know, obviously you probably want to get the ones that look the healthiest and are the largest. All right, so the other thing I decided upon today is the Santa Fe carob. I love carob. Carob pods are great. Much better than eating chocolate. Carob is a wonderful food, really high in fiber. So we have the Santa Fe carob, and these are self-fertile. So not all carobs are self-fertile. They would need a pollinator. So we're gonna get the Santa Fe variety, which is self-fertile, hopefully. And we're gonna get a 1 gallon today, and they're over here. So we're gonna take and pick out a nice one that looks pretty healthy and nice and large. So when you're you know, buying by the pot. You get to, you know, pick out any number of them, and I always like to pick out the largest, most healthiest one. So, let's see, I think this guy looks like the largest one and pretty healthy to me. He has two shoots coming up out of the bottom, a lot of foliage on the top. So, let's go with this. So we're on our way out of the Exotica Fruit Nursery. Had a great time here checking out all the trees growing. Got a couple trees myself, and you know what? They have some amazing deals here. I mean, for only $5, you could have, you know, a guava tree, or, you know, you could have your own chirimoya tree. They're also $5. Red strawberry guavas are $5, you know? So for as little as $5, you could start your own, you know, fruit tree orchard, you know, $5 a tree. It's great. I encourage everybody to visit the Exotica Fruit Nursery here in Vista, California. So this is John Cola with growingyourgreens.com, and we'll see you next time.